Hi, let us start in this lecture classification of discrete time signals. Same continuous time signals, we classified 5 types. In this discrete time signal also, we did same. First one is deterministic and non-deterministic signal. Second one is even and odd signal. Third one is periodic and non-periodic signal. Fourth one is causal and non-causal signal. Fifth one is energy and power signal. Let us start one by one. Deterministic and non-deterministic signal. We know deterministic signal means the signal that can be completely specified by a mathematical equation is called a deterministic signal. That is x of n equal to sine 2 pi n. If you are able to write mathematical equation, we will call deterministic signal. Otherwise, we will call non-deterministic signal. This already we learned in continuous time signal, right? Next, let us see second one, even signal and odd signal. So even signal condition is x of minus n equal to x of n, then we will call even signal. X of minus n equal to minus x of n, then we will call odd signal. Same conditions we used in continuous time signal also. Any general discrete time signal, neither even nor odd signal, but it can be expressed as sum of even and odd signal. So x of n equal to x e of n plus x odd of n. So, if you substitute in this equation completely minus n, then you will get this equation. So, this is even signal. So, you will get same. And this is odd signal. You will get minus x naught of n, right? So, these two equations if you solve, even part of the signal, odd part of the signal, you will get it. Same thing we will solve and same equation we will get in discrete time signal also. Find whether given signals are even or odd signal. So, here x of n signal has given like this. So, you perform the signal time reversal. That is x of minus n. And this is n. 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So, this will come here, right? And this will be here. This is 1, 2, 3. And here, right? And this is 0, 0, right? 1, 2, and 3. So, x of n equal to x of minus n. That means, if you satisfy this condition, we'll call it is given signal is even signal. Now, for this signal, solve time reversal. X of minus n, 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Here at minus 2, you will get like this. At minus 1, you will get 1. At 0, 0. At 1, you will get minus 1. At 2, you will get minus 2. So, if these both are same? No, right? So, it is not even signal. For this signal, I will make amplitude reversal. So, minus x of minus n so here minus 2 1 minus 1 and 1 2 right so x of n equal to minus x of minus n right so x of n equal to minus x of minus n so if you satisfy this condition this given signal is odd signal. Let us see example 3. X of n equal to minus 4 minus 5j, comma 1 plus 2j, comma 4. Find even and odd part of the signal. So, given signal is neither even nor odd signal. Right? So, if it is neither even nor odd signal, it is a combination of even and odd signal, right? So, in this we need to find even part and odd part. So, even part of the signal, how will you find out? X even part of n equal to 1 by 2 x of n plus x of minus n, right? And odd part of n 1 by 2 x of n minus x of minus n. So let us solve this one. X of n equal to minus 4 minus 5j comma 1 plus 2j comma 4. So x of minus n. So just we need to write reverse, right, from here to here. 4, 1 plus 2j, here again we have origin, and minus 4 minus 5j. If you add these two signals, x of n plus x of minus n, here minus 4 plus 4 get cancelled out, right, and imaginary part will be left, right, comma, here 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2 plus 2, 4j. And here real part and real part will get cancelled out. So only imaginary part will be left. And here origin is this one, right? And we need to divide by 2, right? At both sides. So 1 by 2 x of n plus x of minus n equal to, here 5 divided by 2 is minus 2.5 j comma 1 plus 2j comma minus 2.5j. So this is the even part of the signal. X of n. So in this signal, even part is this one. So same odd part, how will you find out? We want x of n minus x of minus n. So we need to subtract this one. So what you will get it? Minus 4 minus 4, you will get minus 8 minus 5j. This is 0. Right? And this is 8 plus 5j, right? And if you divide this one, 1 by 2 x of n minus x of minus n equal to minus 4 minus 2.5j comma 0. 4 plus 2.5 j. So this is odd part of the signal x of n. So in this odd part is this one, and in this even part is this one. If you add these two again, you will get back this signal. If you want, you can verify. X of n, if you add these two, what will get it? Minus 4 minus 5j. And these two if you add, 1 plus 2j. And these two if you add, 4. And this is 0, right? Got it? So in this even part and odd part of the signal, if you add, again you will get back the original signal. Thank you.